Thank you very much, Honorable Speaker, for giving me this opportunity. I do appreciate a showing in the neighbor Lala and Dolobon. Where is NDMA, Honorable Speaker? Because they are supposed to take care of these areas, Honorable Speaker. Where are the people we pay a lot of money as weather forecast department so that they can focus for us so that we can plan ahead, Honorable Speaker? Honorable Speaker, if we can plan in this house and allocate money so that we can feed those who will eventually are affected by the drought, Honorable Speaker, why don't we instead empower the same communities so that come drought, they are already empowered, Honorable Speaker? If we can plan to buy them a sack of maize each, cooking oil and powder milk, why can't we buy for them maize seeds, jembes, and fertilizers in advance so that we can empower them, Honorable Speaker? Honorable Speaker, if we can provide drinking water for them, why don't we provide irrigation water, Honorable Speaker, noting that we have a lot of water in Kenya that is lying above? There is Mount Kilimanjaro, there is Mount Kenya, there is Aberdare Ridges, there is Mount Elgon that have water above that you only need piping system to take to most of these lowlands, Honorable Speaker, and we'll have irrigation, Honorable Speaker. Because why I'm saying this is the drought in Kajiado, Narok, and Northern Kenya, Isiolo, Moyale, Marsabit, and so on, is it worse than the drought that is in the Middle East, like in the Qatar and others? Honorable Speaker, the point is no. It is because these areas have been marginalized for a long time through session paper number 10 of 1965. It is high time, Honorable Speaker, as we organize ourselves, as we organize to declare this drought as a national disaster, as we organize to feed them this year, Honorable Speaker, let us also organize and prepare ourselves in advance so that in future we don't end up with a perennial drought every now and then and people facing starvation, Honorable Speaker, because we can easily turn our lowlands and drylands, Honorable Speaker, to areas like Libya and Israel, Honorable Speaker, if we put in place measures that will assist, Honorable Speaker. Honorable Speaker, our people are really facing death. Our livestock, you know, Honorable Speaker, because you come from Narok South, specifically a place called Loita, where there was that brave Moran, and you are related to the same Moran, who killed that white man who tried to take a bull from him, Honorable Speaker. You know the story. You know those cattle now are dying in large numbers. You have seen that we are migrating all the way to Mau Forest, Honorable Speaker, risking spread of diseases, Honorable Speaker, and people are losing their livestock. There are people who have lost 80% of their livestock. Imagine losing at once 80% of your livelihood. Imagine as a member of parliament, if today you are told your salary will come but minus 80%, Honorable Speaker. This is what these people are facing. So, Honorable Speaker, Madam Speaker, I really plead with this House that let us support Honorable Jeldeza in this move. We declare it a national disaster. Honorable Speaker, because Jeldeza, congratulations for bringing such a very important motion to this House. She is the most powerful woman in this republic, being the Secretary General of the Pastoralist Parliamentary Caucus, the only caucus with 105 members of parliament. Congratulations, and we will support you, and I hope the whole House, including non-pastoralists, will support us in this. Thank you very much, Honorable Speaker. I do support.